In this vlog, we will try to see a state management library, MobX, by using which you can easily handle your reactive data within your application. So, for which we will be adding the dependencies MobX, Flutter MobX, and provider under dependencies, and build runner MobX code gen under your dev dependencies. So I think you have got an idea of what is a dependency and dev dependencies. So dependencies will be rolled out with our application, and dev dependencies will be helpful in our code development. So now let's get started with the code. So first of all, let's import the material.dart package and declare void main, and let's specify run app and inside which provide my app. So these are all the basics, and now let's create a stateful widget called my app. And so from here our actual coding of MobX starts. So I'm going to consider material app, and inside which I'm going to specify a scaffold, and inside the scaffold you can just provide the body here, and also before to the body let's specify an app bar, and here inside the app bar provide the title using a text widget. So here we are going to see the MobX tutorial with the help of a counter example. So first of all, to make it easier for you, I am just making use of a simple concept of counter. I know you have seen many examples with counter, but why I am making use of counter here is like to make you understand the concept. And in our further coming tutorials, we will be using the MobX library to deal with to-do kind of applications. So for the people who are going through the MobX concept for the first time, I want to make it pretty much easy for you. So I am dealing with this particular counter example. So now we can also specify the body, and within the body, let's specify a column, and inside the column, I'm specifying the children. And a text widget first of all. So inside text you have push the button, below which we will be trying to specify the count by making use of an observer. So before getting to the observer, let's get started with our counter.dart file. So here I am going to create a counter.dart file. So now let's specify an abstract class counter with store. So now we need to import mobx.dart package, and now let's specify the observable here. So I will be clearly explaining you what we are doing now. So here we are specifying an integer variable call count and initializing it to 0, and later on we'll be specifying an action also. So with the help of a function, let's call it increment. We are trying to increment the value of the count plus plus. So here comes our counter abstract class, and now let us try to generate the counter.g.dart file. So let's move to the terminal here, and inside the terminal specify the command flutter packages pub run build underscore runner. So this is the dependency which we have specified under dev dependencies in pubspec file, and specify the watch. So now let's try to run this particular command, and here you can see our file will be now generated. So here you can see we have got a message succeeded after 4.0 seconds with 0 outputs here. So now let's try to specify the part counter.g.dart dot dart. So this generated file will be having the same file name like counter dot dot, but between it will be having a dot g which indicates generated. And now let's specify the class counter equal to, we will be providing a mixin here, so don't worry about the mixin, and we will try to see it in our coming tutorials in detail. So we use mixin when we don't have the properties in our superclass and we want to make use of them. So here we will be making use of a mixins. So in our coming tutorials we will be seeing the detailed one. So here, coming back to the terminal, you can see our query is again executed, and now here you can see our counter.g.dart file is now successfully generated, and under lib folder here you can see our file is now generated. So whenever you are trying to make the generation process, you might get some errors, and those errors are based upon your Flutter current version. So you need to upgrade to the latest Flutter version and also make sure you are having the latest version of Dart on your system, and thereafter you need to also update your dependencies. Sometimes you will be getting an error, and if you are still facing errors after doing so, do let me know in the comment section below. And after the file is generated, you need to specify the path and the class here, and then you need to head to the terminal again, and there the remaining work is now been finished. And so this is how our counter.g.dart file is now generated finally, and now let's make use of it now. So here under the my app state, specify final counter. So here we are trying to generate an object for our counter class, and also you need to import dot dart package now, and also I'm going to consider a floating action button, and inside which on pressed you need to specify this particular function which we have created, void increment. So now with the help of the object counter, so counter dot increment. So here you can see we have got that specifications in our counter.g.dart file. So you might be confused that you need to use this particular method, but you need to make use of the increment which is available in the counter.g.dart here. So just make sure it, and also with the help of the observer you need to observe the data which you are trying to emit with the help of an observable here. So with the help of an observable you are emitting some data. So here our observable is an integer variable called count, and we are performing some action here, and the action is nothing but we are trying to increment the number. So that is, we are incrementing the count by 1 every time. We will be trying to fetch the data. So now let's provide a return, a text widget now. So inside which we will be using the counter dot count which is our variable now, and specify a dollar symbol as we are making use of an integer value directly, and encapsulate it with in a single quote, and also specify an icon now, const icon, and specify icons dot add icon here. So now let's try to refresh our code, and here we have got a plus icon on the floating button, but our code is on the top left. So now let's make sure add it a center widget, and now just try to refresh the code, and now let's try to run the code once. So here you can see we are able to increment our number here. So just as a part of an assignment, you can also make sure you add an action decrement and also provide the same variable, and here add one more button, and you can also decrement the value. So By making use of this same concept which we have used for incrementing, you can do the same for decrementing as well. And if you are getting any errors in that execution, do let me know in the comment section below. And also I just want to explain what we have did here. So here you can see the diagram observables. So here our observable is the variable, that is the integer variable count, and here the action is the action which we have performed here, that is incrementing the count, and our reaction is the observer which we are making use of consume the data which we are emitting using an observable here. So now let's get through this diagram once. So observable is an our count variable, and we are performing, we are emitting that count variable, and we are observing that, and we are trying to populate it on the screen here. Here you can see we have got 17. So 17 is an integer variable provided in the observables, and we have emitted it, and using our reactions, that is observer, we have consumed the data and we try to publish it onto our screen. And here the plus button, that is a floating action button, is nothing but the action which we are performing. So whenever you tap on the button here, you are making use of this increment function which we have specified here. That increment function, that is the action which is making the count increase, and again that particular integer variable is being emitted, and our observer is consuming the data. So this is the cycle. So I think you have now understood the concept of the MobX. This is just a sample example to make sure you understand the concept. In our further coming tutorials, we will be getting started with the more examples on MobX. So the code for this tutorial is available in the description section below. And if you are having any queries in this tutorial, do let me know in the comment section below. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.